Welcome back to Fox 8 News in the morning. Think beyond the roses this Valentine's Day and give the gift of health, of someone you love. Absolutely. AJ Battiti, my good friend, is here with some options to benefit more than just your eyes, and wow, and it smells great in here.
It does, and they are beautiful. And speaking of smelling great, so this is a lemon tree, and these things smell so good, I can't even tell you. Let me see if I can get a little guy. If only you had smell-o-vision, but there you go.
I mean, this is gorgeous. This is like natural perfume.
Oh, it's phenomenal.
It's incredible.
They smell so good, and they'll produce lemons.
Yeah.
So as you get towards the end of the season, you'll actually be able to harvest the lemons, and they'll be great. They do really well highlight.
I'm gonna keep this one with me.
Yeah, they're awesome. It's better than a gardenia.
All right.
So if you know what a gardenia smells like, it's better than a gardenia.
Yeah.
But there's so many different things that you can do, and these last so much longer. You know, you give flowers, and they're beautiful.
Right.
And I love giving flowers, but you know, to have a plant in the home is just it lasts longer, it'll be there for years to come.
Okay.
And you can do so many different things with them, and it's great for your air. So we've got some different things. So this is a fiddle leaf fig, so you can kind of see, as a rule of thumb, the bigger the leaf surface area is, the better job it's going to do cleaning the air. So, you know, there's more surface area, more leaves.
Nice. Now, is that difficult to take care of? That's the key. That's the question.
No, and they're easy to take care of. The biggest thing that happens is really just overwatering with houseplants.
Overwatering,
especially in the wintertime.
Okay.
That's number one by far and away. So there's a couple different things that we've got that'll help with that.
All right.
This is a Lachuza pot, and so I love these things. I've got them inside my house, and they're beautiful.
I bet your house is laid out with all kind of beautiful plants and stuff.
There's enough. It's not a jungle, but it's well done.
Yeah.
So, but these make it so easy to have. It's a self-watering pot.
Okay.
So there's a little bubble that comes up.
So how does
it work? A nice, easy way to do it. You plant it, and there's a little bubble.
Okay.
That comes up. You just fill the pot up, and there's a reservoir of water.
Okay.
And so you basically when the reservoir's full, it waters the plant, so it wicks it up through the bottom.
Not a bad thing.
And it works beautifully. And so you only have to refill that maybe once a month. I mean, it's nothing. And it takes all the guesswork right out of it.
Mm-hmm.
If you like having a traditional pot, or if you've got the heirloom, this is the best thing you can have. This is a moisture meter.
Okay.
And so literally you take it and you put it inside of a plant with some moisture in it.
Mm-hmm.
And the beautiful thing about this, and what happens is if you put your finger by the surface, it might feel dry, but down below it might be really wet.
So
that's where in the wintertime you really want to make sure that you're really careful about how much you're watering, you know, whether it's once a week, whether it's once every 2 weeks. It all depends on how wet and how much humidity you've got inside your home.
Now you got some beautiful plants here.
Oh yeah, there's a ton of stuff you can do, especially for Valentine's Day, you know, just taking something. This is a bromeliad, and so this will do well in really high light, but just taking it with a nice pot. And then actually this is a really nice touch. So if you're going to give a gift, or if you're going to make a house plant just for yourself or your home, you know, doing something on top of the soil. So instead of just showing just regular old, you know, plain dirt where it just kind of looks, you know, it looks like dirt, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's not bad, but it looks like dirt.
A little decorative, in a sense.
This is Spanish moss, and then you've got pebbles. You can put that right on top.
Mm-hmm.
It dresses, it takes it to a whole different level.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can kind of just see the difference between, you know, what we've got with that orchid, and then we've got that little daffodil. And so it just looks, it makes it look complete, right?
It just kind of
finishes up the package. And then, you know, after you get done, just put a little leaf shine on it.
Okay.
And it works really well. But some really good plants, some things that you don't want to not have, especially if you've got lower light, because a lot of homes, you've got the areas by the window, and these are wonderful. The crotons, the bromeliads, the citrus, the fiddle leaf fig, even the cyclamen, that little guy down there. But these are great for lower light areas. So if you've got bathrooms, if you've got even within your office.
Okay.
So if you've got an office or a desk inside the office and you don't really know what to put over there, these guys are awesome. So this is what you're touching is a peace lily.
Okay.
It's the old school peace lily.
Okay.
It's one of the best house plants. It's been around for a million years for good reason.
Yeah.
It's one of the best ones out there, and it's great at cleaning the air. So it's just a wonderful thing. And then the one right next to it is probably one and two, is it's called mother-in-law's tongue.
I've heard of it.
It's wonderful, and it holds up beautifully. Same thing with pretty much with all of them.
Yeah.
You just want to make sure that you don't overwater them, but they'll hold up in no light areas. In you really can't hurt them.
This is my favorite, though.
You can't beat it.
I mean, because the smell is incredible. It really, really is. You know,
put it, you know, right inside the kitchen, right by a big bright window, and they're easy to take care of. You know, they will get big. That's the one thing.
Yeah.
You know, over the years, if you have it years and years, and a lot of people do, you know, you'll have them. And then you transplant them every year, and then you transplant them. They'll get larger. But, you know, once they get too big, you can give them to a friend, or, you know, you can donate them. Or, sometimes you got to move on from it. So.
Some ideas other than candy for Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Beautify your home and make it healthy as well.
Absolutely.
I love it.
Beautiful.
Mr. Battiti,
thank you
very
sir.
Much, sir.
Appreciate it.